Spencer. And the crowd, let's see how the reception will be for Joe. Already a face has come out on the giant LED screen here, and there's a huge roar from the Malaysian audience. Certain things that he said recently, it's blown out of proportion in Malaysia, and it'll be interesting to see how the crowd react to Joseph Isaac Schooling.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the pool deck the finalists for event 105 50 meters butterfly men.
So here they come, the men's 50 meters butterfly event, which is swum for only the third time at the Southeast Asian Games. In the previous two editions, has only been one winner, and we expect him to make it three in a row. The only Southeast Asian to make it to the semi-finals and then the finals of the World Championships, in which he finished fifth. And all three times at the World Championships, he dipped below 23 seconds. His SEA Games record is 23.49. And if he swims anywhere close to what he showed at the World Championships, that record is ghost. His competition is not just the clock, but seven swimmers who want to tell their grandchildren that they beat an Olympic champion. That's what it is. Do you have a target board behind you?
I'm not sure if that's going to happen, though, because I mean, looking at the times, Joe has broken 23 seconds. None of the other guys have broken even 24, right? So he's way ahead of everyone. Even when he did it, when he swims the 100 meters, his first 50 is at 23.5. So he's just way ahead of everyone. I mean, Joe's start is amazing. I mean, his start, his underwater, is just top-notch, obviously, as we know.
Glenn Sutanto, silver medalist to Joe Schooling the last two times this event was held in 2011 and 15. Triadi Fauzi, who was fourth in 2015. He was first at the National Championships in Singapore. And here comes the Asian record holder. A record he broke twice at the World Championships. Joseph Schooling, the serpent has arrived in KL. Paul Nguyen, already a bronze medalist at these games. He swims in lane 5. Supakrit Panaratana of Thailand is in lane number 6. He was 5th in this event in 2015. And then 2nd at the Commonwealth Youth Games. Dylan Koo of Singapore swims in lane number 7. Let's see if he can break his personal best of 24.68 that he set in the heats. Tantia of Malaysia, who was 4th at the National Age Group Champs, is in lane number 8. Those are the times to beat. We're not just looking at the SEA Games time, but also the Asian record. Can he become the first ever swimmer to set an Asian record at the SEA Games? There have been a lot of firsts in the Book of Joseph. This might just be another. To let the legacy live. Lane number 4. All eyes are on you. There we go. We talked about how quick he is off the boards. Perhaps a reaction time faster than anybody else. And he's already half a body length ahead of the rest of the field after a superb breakout. Joe Schooling is really going for it. It will be him versus the clock. The rest of them are fighting for second spots. But Joe Schooling will be looking at the clock right now. Can he crack the time of 22.93? This is going to be the most dominant win in a 50-meter race ever in the SEA Games. Almost there. 23.06. It's a new SEA Games record, as we expect, but not the Asian record. But that is a dominant swim for a 50-meter race to win it by a body length. My goodness, this boy, really, really special. Another SEA Games goal. That in itself also the dozen for Joseph Isaac Schooling.
He doesn't even look tired at all after that race. But I mean, what an amazing underwater. I think his start is it's so special, but it's more his underwater kicks that he's really practiced that a lot. I mean, it's something, it's what he's known for, given that all the training he's done in the US, where he trained in yards, short course yards, that he's really honing on in his skills in underwater.
That is a huge victory for a 50 meters butterfly race. No one came close to even sniffing the toenails of Joe Schooling as he just went through the motions, if you like. Ah, that's a lovely gif for I'm the Man, isn't it? He is number one, not just in Southeast Asia, but we all know in the 100 meters butterfly in Asia and in the world. Another win for Schooling.
Ladies and gentlemen,
to add to this huge collection.
Official results for event 105, 50 meters butterfly men final.
With the rate he's winning, look at that, it's almost a second, the difference in a 50 meters event, mind you. Triadi Fauzi comes in second spot with a brand new national record, I believe, 24.01 seconds. Paul Nguyen of Vietnam in third position. And the rate he's winning gold medals and medals at these championships all around the world. Joe Schooling, his dad's got to buy a new cabinet and closet to keep those things in. Well, let's see if we can listen to Joe now.
I'm just going to take it day by day. I feel pretty good. I'm happy to be back in Malaysia. I have a huge team supporting me. My family's over here. So I wanted to do my best. But tomorrow is the relay. That's all I'm thinking about. I'm not thinking past the next day. We're here to have a good meet and to put on a good show. And I think, you know, the crowd wants to see that. And, you know, it's a Monday night, it's a working night, and for them to pack the stands and to come out here and support all of us, you know, that's amazing. So I'm very pleased with the reception. And, you know, I think we'll get better as the days go on. I'm excited for that.
What do you feel about victory in Malaysia, since your mother also from Malaysia, right? So the value of that of their victory?
Yeah, I mean, I love my mom's, I love the woman I love the most in the world, my mom. And, you know, she's from Malaysia and I grew up coming to Malaysia. And, you know, this is a special place to me. And so, you know, I'm back in this part and, you know, just keep my best. Not only for myself, but for my family and my friends that came out here to support me.
Joseph, back to Asia. How did you get the session all the way then?
Yeah, no, it was definitely nice. A little nervous going in. You never know how it's going to be. And so for me, I felt pretty solid. I was happy with the way I felt. And so usually I feel better throughout the meet. And, you know, hopefully I can keep the ball rolling.
Is this maybe a good springboard for the home games in Australia?
That's too far away for right now. Like I said, I'm just focused on my event tomorrow. And Commonwealth Games will come next year when it does. But for right now, I'm just focusing on that 4x1 tomorrow night.
Last year, you and I came from Vietnam, we have the best candidate for the SEA Games. How do you think about the SEA Games this year?
Everyone's gotten faster, really. So being able to come back and to win after a rough summer definitely means a lot to me. You know, in 2015, top 8 in the 50 fly was 28.5, and this year is 24.9. So that really speaks volumes about how fast someone's getting, not only around the world, but especially at the SEA Games.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Okay.